Well, as major wildfires grip large parts of Europe, but there are growing fears Australia could also be facing another horror bushfire season. Our next guest knows all too well the disastrous effects a bushfire can have, witnessing the impact the Black Summer fires had on his Tamaroo. Now he's mayor, preparing his community for the worst. Mathew Hatcher joins us now. Mathew, good morning to you. Thanks for your time. Seeing what's happening in Europe, bringing back a lot of bad memories, I'm sure.
Yeah, good morning, Carl. It is. It's one of those things this whole community lived through. It's tough for us still now to talk about it at times, and that memory of the heat and the smoke that this community and all up and down the east coast of Australia lived with for those months on end is something that's terrifying for the locals.
So, how do you prepare for what's coming then?
Yeah, it's tough. It's been a very dry winter. Some of the windows where the RFS normally would backburn, they haven't had those windows open because of conditions. So I think everyone is a little bit on edge. We've kind of been on edge every summer waiting, but we know this one's, we're being told by everyone that's going to be the worst, sort of brace for it. And we really are urging the community to really get out and make sure their properties are ready.
Well, there's been some complaints from residents that they're not allowed to cut back trees and to create fire breaks of their own. Is that true?
Yeah, it's a tough one. Local council doesn't really try to get into that. It's we're bound by so much state legislation around, I guess, tree trimming and cutting. And when it comes to burning on your property, you know, that's really an RFS issue. So much of your local councils, especially in New South Wales, are bound by the state above us. So, you know, we work with the controls that we have, unfortunately. And what we're telling residents, you know, is to do everything you can for your property, legally, obviously. But really do make sure that you're preparing, that your family knows the evacuation plan, and everyone's ready for what is we're thinking is to come.
I mean, this is the problem, and this is time and time again, local bureaucracy gets in the way of responsible residents doing the right thing to protect their own homes.
Yeah, it's tough. And, you know, trust me, before my time as mayor, I was just like everyone else. And so I see it from a different picture now. So much of it does come from above, our local council. You know, we're there for rates, roads and rubbish. And a lot of the legislation that's set at the state level, it doesn't always impact the way it's meant to. But I guess, again, we work with the means we have. I can't thank, as we always do, the RFS, the volunteers that always come together in times of emergency like this. But it's so important that we do really brace ourselves for it and get ready.
All right. We'll follow this story. Appreciate you being on. Thank you. Sarah. Moving on, Victorian firefighters have been given a 12% pay rise and thousands of dollars in cash bonuses under a new wage deal. Bill, that's a heck of a pay rise.
Yeah, congratulations to the union and the firefighters and the Victorian government. Well done.
This seems to be really heated in Victoria. I mean, I don't have any objection to emergency services getting a pay rise if they can get it. Heidi, you?
Well, Carl, the issue is that the union was going for 26%, so I guess 12% feels like a much smaller amount and much more in keeping with where the public sector wage cap is at. But there's a $7,000 sign-on bonus. That's been repeated several times. There's been $5,000 sign-on bonuses every time we've done deals with the fire services union over the last couple of EBA negotiations. There's also $2,000 a year as a cash bonus for doing your job. And there's talk of wanting to share in the efficiencies. Any efficiencies and savings made inside the fire service, not banking them against the budget, the union members want to be able to share in those savings.
Let's let the little green monsters off our shoulders. Let's the jealousy go. First of all, a cash bonus is less inflationary than baking it into the base rate of pay. So it's not a bad industrial relations solution. You get an improvement in remuneration for the workforce, but it's not baked into the base rate. And also, if the employees are delivering productivity bonuses to the business, why shouldn't they get a share in it?
Okay, Bill, I'm just going to say one thing, if I can. Bill, wage rises can catch like wildfire, right? And they are inflationary. You'd have to concede that. Is this too big?
Well, it's below the inflation rate. So how something below the inflation rate can be accused of increasing the inflation rate, I'm not sure. But let's have the discussion in Australia. You know, some of the media... And some people, you know, they froth at the mouth and say, oh, look, here's a worker getting a pay rise. What about the big corporate bonuses at the top end of town? What about the fact the big banks are making record profits at a time when mortgage holders are crying?
But what about the everyday taxpayers, Bill, who feel like they're being treated like ATMs for things like this?
Well, do you know, Do you know what? I tell you, it feels like treated like an ATM, mortgage holders by the big banks. And by the way, next time your kid gets caught in a car or your house catches on fire or you need rescuing, maybe we could just say thanks to them. I mean, these people rush into danger.
We do say thanks to them and they are remunerated very effectively, very well so far.
And they're going to be slightly better, more upfront.
$2,000 every year from here on in.
Because I actually think they earn it. And good luck to them.
I just want to.
Why shouldn't the workers share in the benefits?
Can we backtrack just a little bit? Where you are absolutely smashing the big banks, Bill? Off you go.
Well, why is it that you know we all get outraged about a firefighter who does day and night rosters, who's highly trained, who puts their life on the line? And yet we get upset if they get a few thousand dollars in an annual bonus, a one-off bonus. Yet we've got the people who, at the top end of town, they're making millions. They're not necessarily helping save lives. And you've got the banks making record profits as mortgage holders are crying tears of blood.
All right.
So really...